Matchbox 20 with lead singer Rob Thomas admitting that he had a crush on Alyssa Milano from Who's the Boss growing up.
Who didn't have a crush on Alyssa Milano? Who was your first celebrity crush, Dave?
The Brady Bunch. I started off liking liking Marsha, of course.
Marsha.
But then I liked her better, Eve Plum. As the show grew and I thought, ooh, Eve Plum, Jan.
For me, it was another kid's show. I used to love Silver Spoons with Afonso Ribeiro and Ricky Schroeder. Now he's the Rick Schroeder, but back then he was Ricky Schroeder.
Wow.
He was so cute.
It's time for Your Mom Must Be So Proud.
Morons.
Dummy.
Idiot.
Fool.
I'm not a smart man.
With Beth and Dave in the morning on Light 98.7.
We got a rare case of a celebrity in the spotlight today for this segment.
Really?
Miranda Lambert.
What?
The former Mrs. Blake Shelton, right?
Yes. What did Miss Miranda do?
She dumped salad on a woman at a restaurant during an argument. Happened in Nashville at the Stony River Steakhouse on Sunday. And apparently, the country singer was dining with her mom and a family friend, and then an older man started arguing with one of Miranda's buddies in the restaurant. And Miranda had to be held back because of the argument that was going on there. Man came up to the table, started screaming, according to witnesses. Soon after that, the Grammy winner, Ms. Miranda Lambert, allegedly dumped a salad on a woman who was provoking her and taking part in this whole thing.
Just want to throw that out there. Who's in trouble here? I don't think it should be Miranda. She was just sitting there eating her food with her friends, and people started it.
I don't care what she was doing. There's no excuse for dumping a salad on somebody.
It was just a salad. It wasn't like a cup of coffee. Are you telling me that in a fit of pique, you have never once in your entire life thrown an item of food or a beverage at another human being?
I don't believe I ever have. I know I've never struck another human being before.
That is not the same thing. Are you telling me?
Yes.
That never, say for example, in an argument with a guy at a restaurant, you've never thrown a cheeseburger at him?
You sound as if you have experience with that, Beth.
I'm just saying.
I bet Gwen Stefani doesn't throw stuff at people.
I bet Gwen Stefani 100% throws stuff at people.
I don't know. I trust Blake Shelton on this one.
She is not fun. She definitely will go for the throat.
Previously on Beth and Dave in the Morning.
Happy Valentine's Day, sweetheart.
Greg called earlier. He wants to know what our big plans were. I said avoiding the plague.
Yeah, right.
From you.
Yes, you'll be putting some gloves on later today.
That sounded wrong, Dave. Wrong. It just sounded so wrong. But we were asking on Facebook, what's the worst gift you could get for Valentine's Day? Someone said divorce papers.
Okay.
I guess that would be up there. That'd be pretty terrible.
It would depend, I guess.
It would depend?
Sure would.
On Valentine's Day?
Hey, if it was what you wanted.
Beth and Dave.
Powered by Kinney Drugs, and they remind you to get your flu shot.
With the best variety of the 80s through today on Light 98.7.
Kids at Maryland's Towson University on the lookout for a woman who's been going around campus trying to get students to date her son. She's been flashing pictures of her son on her phone to cute girls in the library and other locations around campus and asked, hey, would you like, look at my son, he's pretty cute, would you like to date my son? She's about 50, by the way.
That takes helicopter momming to a whole new level.
Yes, which we'll get into in just a moment. Now, they canvassed some of the students on campus at Towson State University to ask for their reaction.
Some people thought it was, you know, kind of sweet, and people thought it was creepy.
I would probably disown her. not really, but I would probably just, like, be embarrassed.
I would just deny that that's my mom.
Right. Do you have a story about your own mom helicopter parenting or embarrassing you when you were a kid or not?
My grandmother actually did it. We were at something called Caesar's Bay Bazaar in Brooklyn, which is basically, it was like a two-story car dealership that was converted into an indoor kind of like flea market, except all the materials were new. So it was like little booths side by side, like imagine like a craft fair, but bigger.
Mm-hmm.
And I was shopping for my first bra. So I was, you know, of course, mortified because there I am with my mom and my grandmother shopping for a bra. And so I'm like walking ahead of them. All of a sudden you hear my grandmother, who was probably like in her 80s, yell in her high-pitched Italian voice, Bethy, they got the bras here, the little ones. Those will be good for you.
Nice.
I wanted to die.
I was about 10. And going out on my first little date with a girl.
Ten?
Well, just a walk. It was a walk around the neighborhood, okay?
Still, early bloomer day.
It was a walk around the neighborhood. And she arrives. We're going to go for the walk. My mom comes outside the house and declares, What are your plans? Like, I don't have any plans. I'm 10, for crying out loud.
I'm going to go for an elegant dinner, and then I'm going to hold her hand aggressively.
Previously on Beth and Dave in the Morning.
Downstate, Beth to the Bronx.
All right, y'all represent.
Where police say a woman attempting to dine at the Back Home restaurant ordered a beef patty. She was told they'd run out of beef patties. She got upset. Authorities say she came back to the Jamaican restaurant with a bat and smashed a bunch of windows up.
Hey, where's the
is she a 4'2" old lady?
Beth and Dave with the best variety of the 80s through today on Light 98.7.